Hi, this is Stephanie with stephaniesrockshow.com. We're here with an awesome, sick band in Austin, Texas right now, Eagle Claw. Thank you guys for coming on the show. You guys rock. Okay, so you're formed in 2007. You're playing tonight as a band. What do you think from 2007 to 2011 you guys have changed the most?
Well, we're not a three-piece anymore.
Yeah, I joined the band.
Yeah.
Mike joined the band.
I'm the newest guy. But
you guys have to do anything to him to accept him in the band?
He got hazed.
Yeah.
Oh, there was no haze.
Not really. I was kidding. We didn't haze him.
No, I slayed all the parts, and they were like, man, I want that guy.
Awesome.
Like, really hung over.
Yeah. So you were kind of a fan before you joined?
Yeah, my old band actually played shows with Eagle Claw. They were called High Cost of Living. And that band phased out, and I started talking to Matt. And he was like, hey, come play guitar, you know, try out.
And, very nice.
Yeah, the rest is history.
As they say.
So how was the Fun Fest? I've yet to be to one yet. We just got out here, but is it pretty intense?
Yeah, it was amazing. Yeah, it was so much fun just to play, you know, in front of all of those people. And, like, outdoors, the production, and, you know, Mastodon played that night, you know, so many other awesome bands.
Huge acts.
Yeah.
So how did you guys come about and get on the ticket? Was there a promoter you met, or?
We recorded our album next to Graham Williams, who throws the festival. We recorded our album, like, right next to, at his neighbor's house, basically. And so he kind of, like, heard us recording and caught wind of the album and liked it and asked us to play the fest.
Neat. So Poacher, your album, is out right now. It's got 9 songs on it, and they all seemed fun, like Milk and stuff. How did you guys come up with these, like, different awkward names of songs?
I don't, it would, like, a lot of them start out as jokes or, well, one of the things I always want us to do is, like, name any idea we have, and then it just kind of morphs, you know, like, somebody will be like, oh, that name's stupid, and it'll change,
well,
but.
We have to have something to call every song.
Yeah.
If you don't call a song something in the beginning, then it goes away and it disappears because it's not anything.
So you guys stick. I feel like you have a lot of one-word song names that are just kind of.
Yeah, we were going for that on that first album.
Yeah.
That's simplicity.
Sure. Simplicity.
And I feel a little bit of like a Black Sabbath or something when I listen to you guys on MySpace. Okay, I heard a little bit of Black Sabbath influence. Is there other bands that influence you guys as well?
Melvins.
Yeah. Melvins.
Melvins, Alice in Chains.
Old Metallica.
Yeah.
Not new. No.
I listen to some of their new stuff. I listen to Death Magnetic.
Yeah. Like it all.
Yeah.
And it's like a little psychedelic too. It's just a very different sound. I dig it. Like, how did you guys come about? Did you get stoned and kind of the sound created, or how did this happen?
Me and this guy got that's pretty much how it happened. But yeah, I mean, me and him got together and decided we wanted to like play something like really slow and heavy, just bass and drums, and then like we started fucking around with guitar ideas, and Matt came in and I don't know, it's not definitely not as slow as like my original intention was for the band, but you know, it's everyone's influences like shine through, you know, and it's definitely like a collaborative effort, you know.
Yeah, definitely.
So yeah, it's lots of getting high and writing parts.
I love it. That's getting high creates the best music. So you guys are huge in Texas. You've blown up, played a lot of places around here. Are you guys currently on a U.S. tour or planning to branch out kind of all over?
Well, we've already done a 17-day tour to like New York and back, and I guess like right now we're planning on something in October. Or,
that was,
you know,
April when we went out in April, so we're already trying to do
another.
Most likely it'll be October or November.
Very neat. Well, you have to let me know if you want to go to LA and play any shows. It's kind of that's what I did, was promote there. So if you guys can get in a van and get there,
awesome.
You're set. Kick ass. So what's your guys' website? We can look you up and.
EagleClawHurts.com.
Yeah. EagleClawHurts?
Yeah.
I like it. So EagleClaw was taken.
Yeah, it's a fishing lure company.
Oh, fuck you, Fisher Luring Company. They're a real band.
No,
that's
they
harsh.
Good fishing lures. So
yeah.
We like them.
They're
you should be sponsored.
They take care of their business.
Out fishing lures at your show.
That would be tight. EagleClaw, fishing lures.
Yeah, promotion. I
Hook
see this cross promoting happening right now.
Just join forces. That would be awesome.
Yeah. So EagleClawHurts.com, check out. They'll be touring soon. Their album's out right now. You can get it on iTunes, CD Baby, anywhere else. Amazon.
Our shows.
Your website.
Show and buy an album.
Okay, yeah. Support the band. I love it. They're playing an emote.
EagleClaw channels on Pandora.
Very sick.
Yeah, that's the next step.
Yeah, Pandora Radio to listen to them.
I don't know. Hopefully it will.
I love it. Well, thank you very much for coming on the show, you guys. I wish you the best of luck. We're going to get a couple seconds of live footage, and I hope you guys rock tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you.